Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will create an autoplay slider using Swiper.js. We'll add a circular timer effect to each slide. It will also have a text animation, which we'll create using Splitting.js. You can also find the live preview link in the description to test it out. Let's get started. Let's begin with the HTML. First, we add the CDN to include Swiper's functionality. You can find the link in the description for more details. Inside the section element, we have a Swiper container. We have 6 slides in this slider. Each slide contains a heading, a wrapper with an image inside, and a description. Now let's move on to the CSS. In this part, we'll create a circular frame, style the text, and add media queries. We'll use 2 different fonts for the headings and descriptions. We center the slider and set the background color. We also add padding to create space around the slider. Each slide will have a fixed width and aspect ratio. These classes have the same width. This ensures that the content inside stays centered and fully visible. We use the auto margin to center the image inside the inner wrapper class. The image fills the circle by setting object fit to cover. We also add a box shadow to give it some depth. We use a different font for the headings and make them uppercase. It is also centered at the top. All text is hidden at first by setting opacity to 0. When a slide becomes active, the text slowly fades in. We'll add media queries to make the slider responsive. The slide and image sizes will shrink on devices smaller than 700 pixels or 400 pixels. Now, let's move on to the JavaScript. In this part, we initialize the Swiper slider and create the text animations. First, we set the slider's autoplay duration to 6 seconds. Now, we create a new Swiper object. We set the speed, which controls how long each slide transition takes, and it will take 1 second. The space between properties sets the distance in pixels between each slide. We use the cover flow effect to create a smooth movement. We enable mouse wheel control so users can change slides by scrolling. Before enabling autoplay, we'll create a setup timer function for the active slide. First, we select the outer wrapper element inside each slide. If this element exists, we reset its background using a conic gradient at 0 degrees. After resetting all slides, we select the active slide. Then we find the outer wrapper inside this active slide. If it doesn't exist, we stop the function and return. If it exists, we record the current time using start time. Now we start a new timer with set interval. This function runs every 10 milliseconds to make the animation smooth. First, we calculate how many seconds have passed since start time. We divide this time by duration to get the progress value between 0 and 1. We use this method to make sure the progress never goes above 1. Then we calculate the angle by multiplying the progress by 360 degrees. This angle shows how much of the circle should be filled. We update the outer wrapper background with a conic gradient using this angle. If the progress is greater than or equal to 1, it means the timer is complete. So we stop the timer using clear interval. We also call it to stop any old timer before starting a new one. Now we set autoplay, so the slider moves to the next slide after 6 seconds. We adjust the disable on interaction to false. This way, autoplay keeps running even when the user interacts. Finally, we add two event listeners, init and slide change. Both of them call the setup timer function. Now we'll add a splitting JS animation for the headings. First, we include the CDN to add its functionality. We use the data splitting attribute to enable animation. We call the splitting function to activate it. We animate each letter inside the active slide. This creates a staggered animation for the title letters. Each letter fades in and moves into place. And there you have it. We've created an autoplay slider with a circular timer effect. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching.